Salamat po. I was given a copy ahead of today, the 10 recommendations, socio-economic programs of the government, and I assure you, we will study and review it. And for now, I would say I see nothing wrong with this. These are doable. It's a matter of just doing it and implementing right away. Now, let me dwell at governance in the light of what I have been schooled. You know, I'm a lawyer, and I never pretended to be an economist. And as a matter of fact, I could hardly pass the subject economics even in college. So I never made any projections about what will happen to this country financially or whatever. And for the many occasions that I was invited, the unanimous opinion was that I did not give any economic programs to present. Now, you must remember that I'm a lawyer and I choose criminal law as my field of specialization. I became a trial prosecutor for about 9 years before I became mayor. Now, in between, I was teaching criminal law, criminal evidence, and criminal procedures, and killing criminals. So, do not expect me to just discuss with you these economic programs, especially taxation. Cesar Verata, the venerable old man of the finance world, told me when I went to him for an advice, and he said, never just agree on anything about taxation. Let the experts in your government do it. The best that you can do is just keep silent and wait for the ready and actionable action that you might want to take on the matter. As I was sufficiently warned about all of these things, and verily, this will be studied by each and every department to where the subject matter belongs. Then maybe I could just read it in its final form and convene the cabinet to give its inputs. But I have no doubt about the people I have chosen to comprise the cabinet. They all are Filipinos, loving their country and rearing to do their share of nation building. Naman, if you want to talk about sentences, indeterminate sentence law, anong klaseng criminal law, crime and criminality, I could give you a lecture for 1 week. We can always stay here for a while and give you all that are really the impact on crime and criminality at governance. Now, when I was a prosecutor, many cases were lost by default because of corruption, changing the evidence from Cebu to Tawas and all of these things. And it is really a lousy government, I tell you. I do not want to offend anybody, but including the police. Kaya hirap tayo. Now, I hold it as an article of faith, having the experience in Davao, that there can be no progress or development of a local government and the community unless there is law and order. Now, you do not compare Manila to Davao. Hindi pwede kasi naiwan. Manila was ahead by so many decades before Davao City came into being. So what I really saw before my eyes unfolding when you came here in 1950, 48, 49. I was just a child. And I saw Davao really grow and grew. And ang nakita ko was during the peaceful times, ang Davao maganda. But came the turbulent years of martial law and anarchy set in, especially here in Mindanao. And there were so many rebellious fronts, insurgency problems, which this country has to cope up with until now. Remember that you cannot have peace in Mindanao. You cannot invest in Mindanao, bring in the materials, dalhin mo dito kung anong makinari mo, because in the end of the day, if you don't pay the taxes, the national people's army will just burn it. And many of you have suffered this kind of fate in some areas. Hindi masyado sa Davao because I was able to connect with all forces acting as the pressure groups in an economy. So I started, we're just talking to the left to leave Davao and stop killing or cutting each other's throat with the government security forces. And then I was able to convince them to go out of the boundaries. Doon na lang kayo sa Surigao. Doon na lang kayo magsunog. Total. Huwag lang dito because it will affect the totality of the fiber of a community. Eh talagang walang mangyari. So how can you invest now and find business in Mindanao especially? Now, ang problema ko because I used just to watch over a small community like Davao City. There are two kinds of forces that would affect this country today. The rebellious fronts, the insurgencies, and the crime and criminality. Dito sa revolutionary fronts, I have realized early on that you cannot outkill each other. No such thing as succeeding in a revolution by killing all of them. Dito naman sa Davao, because right after martial law, as there were a lot of people during martial law giving arms. As a matter of fact, yung Philippine National Police Headquarters, meron silang lathe dyan na machine at the back of the barracks. And they were producing as many guns as there were. Tom, Dick, and Harry would say that he was ready to fight and die against the communists. So magulo. Ang Davao at 7 o'clock was very arid, dry. Wala nang lumalabas. So when I became here, I said, I only gave him one promise. I didn't have a political party. I was yanked out from the prosecution's office to just act as OIC. Because I said, my mother was one of the leading figures of the Yellow Friday here. But she declined the position. I said, if you really want to repay us, then just promote me to be the chief prosecutor. And you can appoint my chief as a judge because that is what you wanted. Ayan, naging ako. But along the way, nag-away kami noong mayor. And so I found myself running in 1988 for the first time, dwelling in politics. Along the way, I became a vice mayor to my daughter and a congressman of the first district. I am now on its 23rd year as mayor of the city of Davao. Now, marami kasi ang nagtatanong, ito si Duterte, magandang kandidato to. And I thought all the while that they were really just joking. To me, it was a bad joke. Kaya ako napipika. Sabi ko, look guys, biro kayo, huwag din yung sobrahan kasi hindi na maganda pakinggan. But I cannot even imagine. Maybe during the campaign, I was perplexed. Na marami kasi ang crowd. The multitude that came to the rallies were just simply very, if it was a dinner, it's what it is, some tourist crowd. Kaya pabilib ko yung sarili ko na mananalo ako. But that was it. I did not have, except for Ilocos, Amy there, at dalawang gobernador. Walang akong mayor, except my fraternity brothers who were running for the local elections. Yun ang nagsuswa. Some ang councilors, vice mayor, may isang mayor. Ayong mga brad ko sa frat. What all others, wala akong, except of course, ito si Carlo Nograles is really my nephew. Ang tatay niya is, tatay mo ba yan, Carlo? We're all is well that ends well in politics. So ngayon, I find myself maybe any poison a few days to take my oath of office. I would have to rely on the cabinet members. Kasi wala akong, if you want me to deal with crime and criminality, wala, champion tayo. If it's just a matter of applying, treating, or whatever, understanding the crime and criminal minds, I could probably say that, I would say that during my time, it was really the best because I won almost all of my cases. And you know, it's very hard to get a conviction of death penalty. But sa record ko, I got 3. It's really, sa kaming mga abogado, mabigat yan. If you go up to the Supreme Court. Otherwise, I'll be just an executive running the show and I'll be hurrying up this department and sabihin mo, you guys, you shape up there. But let me be very brutal and frank to you all. Corruption must stop now. And I would address to all Filipinos who want to do something for your country and never had the opportunity because walang yung nagyayaya sa inyo. Ngayon na ninyo gawin, kasi ako na. Ayaw ko talaga ng corruption. It makes me sick. At sa tawag naman sa Bisaya, pero buyag, I do not know the Tagalog, but sa awa ng Diyos naman, never had in a single graft case about money. Yung ibang mga plaza na sinira ako because ginawa ng tatay nito ni Carlo na wala namang permit sa akin. So he sued me up to the Supreme Court. And I said, well, it's my job to keep the stairs clean. What can I do? That's in the book. Well, of course, it was dismissed, but it was a long and winding battle sa Supreme Court. Ngayon dito sa corruption. I said, no offense intended, I got Dulay. Dito ba si Billy? Billy Dulay? Nga, uwi simula sa Bagyo. Ilocano yun, taga Bagyo. Nainit na siguro dito. Dulay, God damn it, where are you? Alam ka, Bill? Ito si Billy Dulay at si Bebot, magka-roommate yan sila. Sa harap ng kwarto nila, yun yung roommate ko. I was with Yasai. Ngayon nga sabi nila, kinuha ko si Yasai. I was at that time with UP, Padre Paura. Bebot naman pati si Billy, Ateneo sila. Ako sa San Beda. So it's just a mixed crowd there. But most of my friends are really Ilocanos kasi sa dormitorio, they were the dominant tribe there. Alam ko sila. I know Dulay, I know Bebot, Belio. They can really deliver. If they just really would want to do it, they can. Just give you a vignettes of life. Nung sa dormitoryo kami, pagka Linggo, sirado yung canteen. May bowling, So, used to, nakukuha namin sa kamay yung mga stock doon sa taas. I know what Dulay would never participate in that. Ganon ka, ano yung tao. But I'm not saying that he is really 100% honest because I really would not know if he has another woman in his life. We do not go together. Pero honesty in the sense na sa public service, they are imbued. Ang lahat naman kami. Sino pa ba dito? I'm sorry. Senator Soto. Soto. Si Tito. Koko. Ko, medyo yung mata ko na nag-backjab ako sa laser. Pero mas gwapo ka kay Tito. Yung kalaban mo isa nandito. But both of them are my friends and neutral na ko, sabi ko, fight it out. Kasi ako naman talaga PDP. At ang running mate ko during the last election, alam naman ninyo si... Then we have si General Lorenzana, who used to be assigned here sa Davao. Anong namili ako, I could not... Pinaka-stricto ng lahat ng stricto. Bihira ito tumatawa, just like Galvante. Si Galvante doon sa pre-departure, nakaupo dito sa sofa, nandito siya. If this is the sofa, no? Yung aid niya, kalahati ng puwit, kalabas na doon sa... Ganon si Galvante. Pati yung aid niya, kalahati lang yung puwit na ka... Ay, nako. And almost all are really valedictorian. Sane, consistently. Ako hanggang... Second year lang ako sa atin kasi na-expelled ako. Punti. Naiwan. But ito sila, sana, consistent valedictorian. Lahat yan sila puro mga otak. Puro 95 yan lahat. Ako 75 lang. Pero yun, sometimes, it's really a strange thing. Maybe by destiny. That lahat yung mga scholars noon sa UP, sa ano, mga bata-bata lang ng mayor sa Davao. ako naman, since grade school, talaga hanggang dyan lang, 75, 76, 77. Milag doon masyado yung 80. I do not even think I got an 80 in high school. 75 lang, dahan-dahan lang. 7 years sa high school, kaya nauna ito sila. Layas dito. It took me 7 years to finish high school, actually. Pero, how would you call it? Destiny? Maybe wala akong, except si Aimee yung mga, when openly went out to, wala akong, except mas of course my nephew, wala akong congressman, wala akong vice mayor, wala akong isang barangay captain outside of Davao. Kaya ko, na-mesmerize ako noong sa crowd, because marami palagi. I thought that, pwede, but ngayon, thinking about it now, I'm really dumbfounded how I made it. Walang kinarya, walang pera, huwag tayong malakay, trillanes. Meron ang taga-BPI dito, di buksan ninyo yung ledger ko. Oo na. If that's a guy from go to him and I am authorizing you verbally in front of people, open the ledger. Ang yung pera na yon galing sa Congress yun, when I was a congressman, sinindiposito ko yung pera ko doon sa bangko. Ano, yung may dollar account, sobra yan sa binibigay ni Senator Tatay ni Senator Villar because he was the speaker at the time. Every time we go out of the country, we're provided with... Hindi naman ako mahilig magbibili, so every time I go out of the country, and what was the only time that I was going out of the country, previously, hindi ako nakakalakad. Wala akong gana kasi, except when I was a congressman. So yung mga sobra, we are given actually $5,000 per congressman if you go out. So ang magastos ko lang yung mga lilit na... So kaya naiwan nga, magkano yun? $5,000? Tapos dinipositohan ni Mar ng $20 sa... Na-trace namin yun sa bangko ng Cubao. He was just actually trying to find out whether it was extant or still alive. Pero yun lang, okay mo naman. Trilya. And it's all garbage. That is why also I said, I have some my heartaches. Because the owner of a network, once upon a time, maybe, well, and he said, you know, balita namin, kabarkada mo yun. We got this paper. Saan yung ko? Blanco. Pinirma ko. Tanungin mo. Tapos kinagawin, they were trying to invite me. Alam niya mismo. He had an experience with me. Kasi yung mga, ang owner to the country, cable, may mga taga-Davao na entrepreneurs. At pumasok sila. Tapos pumunta sa hotel. Well, ano, I would like to ask you because mga kaibigan mo, baka magalit ka. Eh, doon ako na, ano, bakit ako magalit? And why would I take it against you? So saan yung papel niyo? Blanco pa. Tanungin mo siya. Pinirmahan ko. And always yung campaign man, I said, no. He knows it. Kaya minsan, basura na itapon mo na tapos patulan mo. Huwag naman sana ganun. The modern day paradigm of almost all, well, some are really outright idiots. Kasi wala na yan sa kanila, lalo na itong American concept of human rights. Wala na yan as long as you are not really endangered of a species na about to die. If you are in front of a criminal and all of these things, mamatay. Gaya na itong mamatay ngayon ng mga... Sabo, ano yan sa kanila? Criminal law book itself in defense against honor and defense against life and defense against honor carries with it so many mitigating. Sa kanila wala na, babuhin ka lang nila, okay na. And they would ask, kaya sabi ko, kung ganun, putang ina ninyo, kasi magsilayas kayo, ganun kayo. Boycott. Beginning today, umalis na kayo. So I don't give interviews anymore. Mga one-on-one. Yung mahirap yung tapos i-confront ko at sabihin, alam mo, negosyo rin kasi ito eh. Ay putang ina mo. Bitse ka. Ganun ka na lang kung magsira ka ng tao. Kasi Pilipino, importante yung mukha niya. Honor. Kayo mga abogado, go back sa the basics of fundamentals. It's there. You can even want to defend honor. You are dishonored or in danger of dying because somebody is threatening you. That's criminal law. Nawala na kasi ano, kaya nga, eh, gusto lang man pala ito, edi, bakit eh, mag-usapan ng iba? Then I'll talk to you when I have business with you. Well, anyway, yan ang ano ko. Hindi ako trust dyan. Corruption. Yan sa airport tanim na mga, wala na yan. Kakainin mo talaga yung bala, maniwala ka. Hindi ako nag-ihabang. Iharap mo. Pag inabot ako ng bakukang, laki kasi ng tainga ko, sabi tainga, pumapasok yung mga kanong insekto. Pag mayroong isang umiikot dyan sa utak ko, pain kita, publiko. Wala na. Ay, lahat sinabi ko to. It has to stop. Kasi matagal na kulata, masyadong bugbog ang Pilipino. They've never really had a government na masabi nila na at least ngayon, medyo wala. Ang sa BIR, customs, kaya nandyan si Paildon. Yan silang inaasahan ko because it's estimated that we're losing about 300 million pesos daily sa corruption all over the ports of the Philippines. BIR siguro, same projection. So kung makulikta lang nila, hindi wala na tayong problema. I could go as far as really enhancing the, lalo na yung rural. Pero ewan ko kung anong sinasabi ng mga NDF kanina, I've read about, nagmamadali ka about land reform. You know, the law has already passed away. And I want really to know anong klaseng land reform. Because if you just go back to being just a confiscatory, nonchalant attitude, no, I will not agree with that. Mahirap yan. Kasi karamihan ng lupa na ibigay doon sa mga tenants, bumabalik naman doon sa mga landlords. Well, the only consideration, or maybe the thing that would make me happy, is that at one time in their lives, they were able to hold that much money. At least they enjoyed for the moment in this universe. Takahawak sila ng pera na malaki. Yun lang, at least natikman nila. Yun na lang ang konsuelo ko, but to go into a confiscating other people's property, I will not. Eh, balik muna tayo. Let us go back and review. And if I think or there is an improvement in the lives of the people who were awarded lands, baka pa. Eh, pero kung ganito lang ang nangyari, lahat na pinagbili na, okay, has been returned, there was a buyback thing there, I will have to think 1,000 times. Dito sa criminality sa droga. You know, hindi naman ako nagyayabang kasi hindi naman mayabang na tao. Pati, storya mo lang yan. In the campaign, in all of my sorties, I really warned everybody that do not destroy my country because I will kill you. And do not destroy our children because I will kill you. And if Dilima does not shut her mouth, I will kill her. With love. Kung pumayag siya, I don't know. Ang ano talaga is, zero tolerance ako. My standard would be zero tolerance sa graft, pati sa criminality. Aywan ko kung anong klase ba. Hindi ko talaga tatanggapin yan. I would never preside over the affairs of this country with a corrupt police and drugs abound destroying the lives of Filipinos. Pumunta ka sa likod ng Pasay. Ganang bata doon, bata, pati matanda, nababayan dyan yung may gasoline station, tingnan mo yan. Ganang. Greeting this. Isa ho yan. Parang matulog pero yung gising. Tingnan mo yung mga matanda. Eh kung sabihin mo lang ang tinamaan mga able-bodied o yung talagang matanda na, that's okay. Maybe mapalusod ko pa yung, pati yung bata o matanda. You have crossed the line, the red line. And I just warning you, not because I'm the president-elect. If you do not do something with the situation, 7 years from now, this country will become a narco-politics. Yung mga mayor na may backers na sa droga or who are into drugs, nananalo sila. About, I named about 32. They don't really care. Hindi sila naghintay kay BNI sa pera ni BNI o mga goodies ng liberal. They just went ahead to run and winning the elections because of drug money, which comes very easy. Yan ang bantayan niya. Pero ako po, as long as I'm nandito sa gobyerno, I will not allow it. Hindi ko makaya mag-upo-upo ko dyan sa opisina ko tapos knowing that people are suffering because of the greed. Ang problema, because pati police tinamaan. NBI. Ang better off lang dito, si kay, ito sila kay Delphine, General, his name is Delphine Lorenzana. Kasi ang mga sundalo kasi, they cannot go out of the camps to enforce the laws. Itong mga police, they are the ones who go out and enforce the penal laws of the land and yung violations ng ordinance. So, invariably, tao por tao sila. Ngayon, huwag na ninyong pakialaman kung ilang namatay dyan. Tsaka sabihin mo na kung kilala ninyo si Gascon, baka kumpare ninyo, hindi ako susunod sa kanya. I will not. And let me, I said, be very blunt. If they kill upon my orders, akin yan. That's mine. Kapag dinalang ka ng supina ng ombudsman, ano, sabihin mo, padala mo kay Duterte yan. Akin. Ang sinasabi ko lang sa police and all law enforcement, huwag lang ninyo akong ipahiya by lying to me. If you have committed a crime for personal reasons, tell me the truth. I will help you. Pero kung ipalusot mo na utos ko ng gano'n, ikaw ang isunod ko. And the mayors. Itong mga mayors ng Pilipinas who are into drugs, I will catch up with you. At pag nagkita tayo sa isang, if we meet in one corner, then I don't know. Minawarningan ko talaga, lalo na yung nandyan na sa gobyerno. Ito namang police, pati NBI, kung hindi ako nagputak-putak doon sa Pasay incident, nung hindi maang namatay, sumabog ang mga ulo. Sabi ko, ano klase ito? And I said, prepare a massive revamp. Kinaumagahan, marami nang nahuli. Ngayon, marami nang patay. Anak ka na. Pinatay nila, yun ba? Baka yung pinatay nila, yung bata nila, para hindi na pumiyait. But I should know. By this time, mga said, prepare a massive revamp. Because I need around one company of police. May special assignment ako sa kanila. In the meantime that I'm talking to the several factions here in Mindanao, because some of those holding arms may have possessed them in connection with the Mindanao issue. Kaya kita ko, I never classified yung rebellion, NPA, MI, never mentioned about crime. But if we can solve the problem of Mindanao by just talking, I would be very thankful to God and I would be ready to even to step down. If I can just bring, because if you cannot really improve, alam mo sa Manila, maybe there is peace, but do you have order? It's part of the law enforcement kasi yung law and order. And, You have the law, you cannot enforce it anymore because it has become a physical improbability. Kaya kung mag-asa ka lang kay Tugadit to solve it using his saliva, pwede ko sabihin ko lang at pahinga ka lang. Eh, laway lang pala ang kailangan sa'yo. So if you're not ready to cooperate with the guy, okay na, we solve the problem dyan sa... And there are the dynamics of our times now. Yung South China Sea. I've repeatedly said that we will await for the arbitral judgment. Then I will decide. Pero nandiyan na yung aircraft carrier sa South China Sea ngayon, patrolling. And if the Americans would say, come join us in an expedition, so, sorry, I will not go to war because of the Scarborough Shoal lang. You know, the Scarborough Shoal is not a territorial issue. It is an issue of our exclusivity sa economic zone. That you place there obstructions that would impede or obstruct our right to develop and fish there anywhere. Yun ang contention. That is our ache. But that is not a thing to just say that we will go to war. We only have what? 2 F-50s? Bakit mo binili yan? Kayong mga taga-Air Force, do not misconstrue my... I'm a Filipino, I'm a citizen of this country, and I have every right to say what I want to say. Sayang ang pera doon. You cannot use it for anti-insurgency, which is really the problem of the moment. Can you use it only for ceremonial flybys? Why do I care about that? Eh, kung binili mo ng choppers yan, that may night vision, you know, when the kidnapping, hindi ang akin yun. It's about was Davao del Norte yun. Pero the CASAP is just, Air Force was just about 3 minutes away. If we had the night goggles, night vision, we could have caught up with these guys, and kung may fast boat tayo, we could have pursued them because they were traveling from that night. This time they traveled to be passed by Kiamba. Then diritso na sila. Eh, mapahuli pa sa natin. Or right after, when the owner called me, we could have called the CASAP, the pare ninyo. 2-3 minutes nandoon na. On the night goggles, we could have spotted them even in the dark night time. So these are the things that I say na hindi naiintindihan ng lahat. I don't mind for display purposes because there's only one purpose for buying it, to match the air power at least at one-on-one sa China. Pero beyond that Scarborough Shoal, anak ng waiting, there are 300, according to the intelligence, 300 MiGs there. We can reach Manila in 6 minutes. And why would I go to war? Ang battleground mo, Palawan? Eh, loko-loko ka pala eh. Now, if you want to do battle sa San Francisco, okay lang. Magpadara ako ng ano nun. You know, when you go in my aircraft carrier dyan, let me give you the logic. Ordinarily kasi sa mga tokatis natin, kasi of Navy, you know, when we talk of gray ships, gray kasi ang pintura ng... the Navy. Then if you see white, that's for the Coast Guard. Kung padaraon ka ng gray ships doon, that's not amount to aggression. Natinanong nga ako ng ano, sabi ko sa kanila, if I were to go around the reef dyan, Scarborough and all, kasi tinanong ko si Goldberg, Ambassador. Sabi niya, what do you intend to do? Sabi ko, well, if there's the arbitral judgment, I will go there. But hindi ako, Coast Guard lang. Because hindi pa na panggira yan. Coast Guard is just a the name employee. You guard the coast, that's coast guard. De, yun lang muna. Pero kung magpadala ako ng mga Navy dyan, ah, kalukuhan. We are not in a position to just a massacre. I will not waste the lives of people. Yeah. No, Filipino. We are better off just solving the internal problem first. Then we can open up tourism and investment, especially sa ano. Maraming isda dyan sa Tawi-Tawi, banda sa Pacific. They are dying of boredom. Maghihintay lang yan sila. Kito ka mapunta ng kuhan. But of course, talking now of military issues, naturally, we are allied with the Western powers. We have a defense treaty agreement with the United States that was hammered out in the 50s. Ang problema doon, there's a provision na declaration of war must come from the Congress of the United States. Eh kung hindi sila magbigay, sabi ko kay Goldberg kasi, naman na niya, what do you intend? Sabi ko talaga niya, and you can ask him, are you, is the United States, are you with us or are you not with us? Because if I may decide based on the judgment, I will now start to claim there. Kasi ang sabi niya, you know, only if you are attacked. Oh, sabi ko, I'll give you an example. The law of the Sea of Nations gives us the exclusive rights 200 kilometers. If I go there using the privilege of mine, would that be an attack against China or an offense against China? Paano? Mamabuti ang prangkahan. Tayo, we are allied with China. No, with the... But China, same thing, even before the elections, the ambassador, yung babae, sabi niya, we will do the railway immediately. Sabi niya, immediately. Once you're there, we will start immediately. And we will solve your Clark Manila run. In two, we will use the, no more, we'll use the shoulders of the road. I don't know how would they do it. But we will complete it in 2 years and give it to you. So you are doing it in Africa, we'll do it in Mindanao. I said, do not forget the Tutubana Bicol run and Batangas and the improvement. We will help you. And they have not asked for anything because at that time I was not ready to talk about China also. I was just asking how can you help us because sabi ko balik art to God has to go to China. Not to talk about war, not to talk about irritations there, but to talk about peace and how they can help us. Meron sila. Okay. Can you match the offer? Because if you cannot match the offer, I will accept the goodwill of China. Mine is to promote peace in my country and to see to it that the people are comfortable. If I cannot give them the luxury of the moment, then I will say, your children will have the streets back to them, to the citizens. Yung mga standby, they have to congregate somewhere else. I will open Corregidor and Carballo Island Port. Doon sila mag-picnic. Doon ko nasirain yung barko nila. Ayaw ko na. The streets of Manila and everywhere else in the Philippines must be returned to the citizens. Na hindi na pagkagabi takot ka sakay ng bus mo. Yan ang mahirap. And again, this Abu Sayyaf. Just give me the luxury of time. I cannot do it just immediately. There are things which I need, which we don't have now. But there will be a time, there will be a reckoning. And when it comes, I would just say, surrender unconditionally. Release all prisoners, hostages, or we fight. But I have to have a firm commitment from our brother Moro about the continuity of the talks. Hayaan na muna yan. Huwag silang suma. As soon as I get that guarantee na talagang peaceful ang intentions ninyo and you are not protecting terrorists, then, and when I have it in my hands, I'll be ready to confront. Meantime, and if we confront them, we confront them. Tapusin na talaga natin para wala naman. So that ang my dream is really that one day all Filipinos, we'll just say Filipinos, and we do not at all mention his left or right. He's a Moro rebel or a Moro terrorist. And we can live in peace. I have 6 years to do it. I do not know how many concessions God can. Pero ginawa naman niya ako ng presidente, di sana tulungan niya ako. Kasi, for I really, I'll end this by saying, I'd like to thank you for voting for me. Hindi naman lahat. Siguro, mga sampo lang kayo dito. Ay, kasi, look, ganito yan, ha? One more thing. Para maintindihan ninyo ako. Sabi nito, kayo taga Maynila, do not be too judgmental about the person. Sabi, ito si Duterte ang kinuha, mga kabarkada, kainuman, at mga kasama. Look, I am really tied in the wall, provinciano. No? Mag-aral kami dito. And so whatever the trickles and about the culture ng Manila, it came so. Lalo na lahat akala nila ang Davao Bukid. So, ang nakilala ko dito sa buhay ko, mga taga Davao. Hindi naman ako niyaya ng mga social sa Maynila. Sabihin pa nga, wala kang alam sa economic. Gago ka pala eh. Eh, sinasabi ko na yung abogado ako, economist na yan. Mamili kayo ngayon, nandiyan na. Ah, sige. Si Pernia sa UP, si Sunny Dominguez. Sige, mamili kayo dyan. Bakit ito? Walang economic, gago. Nabi ko na nga, halos bagsak ako dyan sa economics na. Eh, ayaw ko yun, nakakahilo yan, ganun-ganun na. Dito, tumaas, tapos lugi na bukas, tapos, eh, kung ganun negosyo po, putang, eh, nahuminto ka na. Dito, down. Ito, gumbuta doon, tumataas. Ito, good na, good na. Tapos, biglang bumagsak. So, pagkahilo ka na. Ito, titingin ko nung, sa librong sa gitna. Ang klase economics to. Kung ganun ang negosyo mo, palugi, huminto ka na lang. Bakit ka mag... Well, ganito yung punta akong Maynila, nag-aral ako. Kung sino ang mga kakilala ko? Hindi, mga classmates ko. Mga kasama ko sa dormitoryo, yung mga brad ko. Yun lang. Wala naman akong noong, hindi, mga ako tagalasal ko, sinong valediktoryan, sino siya. But when the time came, namili ako ng team. Kasi si Vit Aguirre, na acquit niya si Herbert. Magkano ang nakita mo doon, Vit? It's no mean feat to, you know, the guy was in prison po. Tanong lang na, lawyering yan eh. Kung ayaw mo mag, ano, Bebot Alvarez, DOTC na yan. Ngayon, speaker.
So, anong masasabi mo sa... Kayo, gusto ninyong magdagdag, kunin ko kayo. Just raise your right hand. Ah, you know, the president has the prerogative of naming a title somewhere, attaching it to raise it to the level of a cabinet member. Mas papayo kung lahat kayo dito, gusto ninyo. Bigyan mo yan sila ng pang-profile one. Now I have to stop. Is that joking? But really, really, seriously now. Mayroon akong, for example, like flow of goods and services, you have to have, of course, seller or buyer, you have to have the cheapest, the fastest, and the safest way to do it. Those are the fundamentals of ang ano ko sa, hindi naman talaga yung, ano, yung pang-college lang, maintindihan mo. Mayroon dito, ano, even the curriculum. Sabihin ko kay Ma'am, tignan mo muna yung, ano, yung mga calculus, isa rin yan. Cosine, equals sine, equals sine, plus one, plus one, gamitin mo na yung one, two, and three, bakit gamitin mo na yung plus sine, matutuloy rin. But, I was good at algebra ko, 87. Pero, I'd rather replace it business math. Yun lang. Pero yung mga calculus, mga chemistry, malay ko ba po ito? Yung Muriatic yan. For all of its practicality sa buhay. Wala naman sa ano, drama-drama dyan. Kaya, forgive me really if I fall short of the expectations of an economist. Si Sane yan, sila kasi hindi nahihilo dyan sa graph. Nag-flatline, pagtipis lang bigla, kumita ito, ito, house yaw to. Mining na, mining, I forgot. You know, si Gina Lopez came to me yesterday. So she's an ardent for responsible mining. Pinakita niya yung mga butas na kung anong-anong pinagagawa. Ako, let alone, ang sentimento ko sa mining, ganito yan. Improve on it, actually. When you reach at the end of the field, your small-scale mining, I want the trees planted. That would be how many years. Kailangan mayroon ka na. Pati yung washing of the chemicals. If you do not do it, I will cancel the permit, the concession. Ay, maawa ako sa bayan ko na i-travel yung campaign mag-helicopter. Although intermittent spaces, pero parang tansa ng Coca-Cola ang buta. There will be a comprehensive review of the mining claims or concessions given.